Haven, a lunar port and base at the South Pole by Sabrina Kerber. Haven is a lunar arrival port and long-term habitat located on a ridge between Shackleton and De Gerlache craters at the Lunar South Pole. The lunar port and base is designed as the initial location for arriving crew before they move on to resource outposts or other habitats. This unique design accommodates two crew types: a permanent crew that staff the base for 6 months at a time, and guest crew who briefly stay at the habitat to acclimatise before moving on to perform tasks at other locations. The idea is that visiting crew may not be professional astronauts. Instead, they could be scientists or engineers, or perhaps even tourists. The arrival port allows them to adjust to moon gravity while receiving training from the permanent crew. Sabrina Kerber, an architect with expertise in space habitation, created this design for her 2020 master's thesis at Vienna University of Technology. She consulted ESA senior scientists, including the Euro Moon Mars team, analog mission crews, and Apollo astronaut Charlie Duke. Her 187-page thesis, linked in the video description, balances privacy with training and team building to address isolation and confinement challenges. Kerber minimized mass to reduce launch costs and assembly needs, balancing trade-offs between space and mass due to the high expense of transporting mass to the moon. The habitat offers 73.5 cubic meters of habitable volume per crew member for up to 8 astronauts, with 4-meter ceilings for low gravity movement. It adapts International Space Station technologies from NASA and ESA for life support, temperature control, and fire suppression. Systems also combat electrostatic abrasive lunar dust through soot ports that help prevent contamination. Kerber selected the connecting ridge for its near-constant sunlight from nearby peaks of eternal light, gentle 9.2-degree slope for rover access, and proximity to scientific sites and resources like water ice in Shackleton and nearby craters. NASA eyes this area as a candidate for Artemis missions, including the Artemis base camp. All of these reasons make the location of the base a good choice, and one widely agreed upon by other lunar-based design teams who have all chosen this site on nearby locations. Next, we explore Haven's key facilities, floor plans, mission timeline, operations, and a few design concerns. Key areas and facilities. The Haven compound contains separate areas for habitation, energy generation, launch and landing, and component storage. The launch and landing pad is positioned 2 kilometers from the habitat to protect the crew from any hazards caused by landing or launching spacecraft. The storage hangar and lunar resource processing zones lie between the habitat and the landing pad. The unpressurized hangar, shielded by regularly filled bags, houses transport vehicles near the pad for quick payload transfers. It also stores landers during crew stays. For extra radiation shielding, crews fill empty propellant tanks with regolith and place them around the habitat, topping it with regolith-filled bags. Let's go over the key areas and facilities in this design. Launch and landing pad. For safe operations, the launch and landing pad is situated at a distance of 2 kilometers to minimize hazards from spacecraft operations. Energy and resource facilities. These zones generate power, likely via solar arrays given the site's near constant sunlight, and process excavated lunar resources such as water ice. Storage hangar. This regolith shielded structure stores vehicles and landers, enabling efficient logistics. Habitat. The habitat is a hybrid structure consisting of a rigid central module, 80 cubic meters habitable volume, which expands into an inflatable torus, 587 cubic meters or 515 cubic meters per some notes, yielding 667 cubic meters total. The inflatable folds around the rigid core during launch, occupying 187 cubic meters packaged. Future heavy lift launchers like Starship and New Glenn can easily transport this compact form to the moon. The lightweight composite rigid core measures 4 meters in diameter and 8.8 meters high, including a top cupola for observation. The inflatable exterior fabric uses multi-layered materials for protection and durability. Habitat spatial layout and floor plans. The habitat spans two levels, surface and subsurface, connected by a lunar staircase in the rigid central module. The subsurface level is where the crew quarters and leisure facilities are located because the lower level has superior radiation protection. First, let's look at the top or surface level. Surface level, work and greenhouse. The surface level facilities are focused on work and communal activities, featuring a wardroom, galley and a greenhouse. The floor plan is centered around a green gallery relaxation space, featuring a green wall for psychological benefits. The circular layout links spaces through the green gallery, using greenery to separate zones. The cupola, or domed window, is accessible by ladder, where it overlooks the area and helps alleviate the feelings of confinement. Greenhouse. The greenhouse is an inflatable structure connected via an airlock. This allows the environmental conditions to be set for optimal farming conditions. It grows fast-yielding crops like tomatoes, peas, and herbs for vitamins, minerals, and meal enhancement. Larger setups could include wheat, soybeans, sweet potatoes, and rice, aiming for 15 crops for a complete menu. Beyond nutrition, plants offer sensory benefits, textures, smells, and growth to boost mental health. The greenhouse is not meant for interaction with astronauts. Its sole purpose is to grow fresh vegetables and herbs to sustain the crew. Working areas. Kerber includes a communications and control center, permanent crew only, for links to Earth and outposts, a flexible training area for guests, divisible into pods or workspaces, and a shared wardroom galley to support social bonding during meals. Airlocks. The Haven habitat is fitted with two airlocks for entering and leaving the habitat. Both provide four suit ports, which allow easy access into spacesuits. External lockers hold all equipment necessary for EVA missions. Airlock 1 is used as the main airlock, while Airlock 2 is for use by the permanent crew only. That airlock is used for research and exploration sorties or for maintenance tasks. The value of two airlocks is redundancy. It's a critical piece of infrastructure, so multiple independent airlocks enhance safety of the crew. Comms area, permanent crew only. The communication and control center in the Haven habitat is restricted to the permanent crew only, as it houses critical systems and serves as their primary workspace. This access limitation ensures uninterrupted operations and privacy for managing launching landing procedures and communications with Earth or other outposts. While guest crew don't have access to this facility, they can still communicate with Earth via a separate private communications chamber on the surface level. This can be used for non-critical or personal communications with Earth. Pantry storage and galley. The pantry is positioned next to the galley and wardroom for efficient food preparation and storage. All crew share meals in the wardroom to promote interaction, relaxed exchanges and bonding, essential for a healthy social environment and mental well-being. Now, let's descend to the lower level. Subsurface level, quarters, leisure and safe haven. The subsurface level is better shielded from solar flares, cosmic radiation and micrometeoroids, making it the ideal location for the crew sleeping quarters and leisure areas. In the center of the level is a large common crew lounge, offering stargazing views through the overhead cupola and glimpses of the surface level green gallery. Separate quarters and hygiene zones provide privacy for crew members. The permanent crew quarters are larger than those for guests. Virtual windows in all quarters stream lunar or Earth views to provide mental relief. Crew quarters, separated by crew type. The Haven lunar design has two crew types, permanent and guest, and this is reflected in the crew quarters. Permanent quarters are larger and allow for upright movement, extendable beds for dual use, ample storage and personalization so that space can be adapted for work or gatherings. Pod quarters for guest crew. The design equips guest crews with tiny yet comfortable pods that offer privacy and personal storage for each member. Guests reside at the lunar base for 5 to 10 days post-arrival to acclimatize, learn safe navigation in lunar gravity, and prepare before moving out to research posts or long-term habitats. It stacks two pods vertically to maximize valuable space. Each includes a fold-out table, rotating media screen, and control panel for ventilation and lighting. Hygiene and laundry units are separated between crews. The workout area is configurable with sliding walls for individual or group exercise. A sick bay and medical lab can double as overflow during handovers. Access restrictions such as the permanent crew-only zones for critical systems ensure workflow, while shared spaces like the lounge and wardroom build bonds. Mission timeline and operations. Haven's deployment unfolds in four phases. Phase 1, preparation and pre-staging. Extensive satellite and robotic exploration first maps the environment. A series of lunar landings using robots will be used to place the habitat at the correct location and position all needed support equipment. Phase 2, construction. Robots handle most construction, including site preparation, module deployment, and shielding. The first crew finalizes interiors while living in their lunar lander until the habitat pressurizes and activates life support. Phase 3, initial habitation. Installation of non-critical systems while the crew is already living in the habitat. At this stage, no guest crew are present until the permanent crew have acquired expertise in living in lunar gravity and running the base. Phase 4, arrival port. Guest crew arrive, up to 4 astronauts staying for 5 to 10 days at the base. After that, they either move to a lunar outpost or go back to Earth. Despite effective radiation shielding, permanent crew stays are capped at 180 days to avoid health risks from prolonged non-Earth conditions. Similar to International Space Station handovers, overlapping stays allow new crews to acclimatize, learn procedures, and acquire specialized lunar skills. The 4 permanent crew members rotate in pairs, not all at once, so juniors learn from seniors before the seniors depart. Concerns about crew status separation. I'm not entirely convinced that separating crew members into different status groups, with one group, the permanent crew, enjoying larger quarters, exclusive facilities like a private airlock and restricted zones, helps crew bonding. It could evolve into an us and them type situation, especially under lunar stresses like confinement and high-stakes environments. An event, no matter how minor, could act as a flashpoint, surfacing grievances about unequal treatment. This base setup seems to deliberately set up a hierarchy between crew, which could damage essential social bonds rather than help them. A review of ice analogs, including Antarctic overwintering, links perceived inequalities in access or privileges to motivational drops and friction, with disparities sparking flashpoints during shortages or disputes. Evidence overwhelmingly indicates that unequal treatment, even if operationally rational, can breed resentment and us versus them divisions. Given lunar stresses, radiation, confinement, delays in Earth support, this setup risks amplifying tensions if not mitigated. NASA's 2024 evidence report on team risks warns that analog studies show inequalities in long-duration missions leads to low performance with us versus them dynamics emerging from perceived unfairness. The short stay of 5 to 10 days for guest crews in a lunar base like Haven would likely mitigate many risks of social tensions by limiting the time available for resentments to build into chronic issues. However, it may not fully eliminate short-term flashpoints, especially in the intense, mistake-intolerant environment of space. There was a recent incident of violent and potentially violent behavior at the Sine 4 research base in Antarctica in March 2025, involving a South African scientist accused of assaulting a colleague and making death threats against team members. The event left the isolated team pleading for rescue amid encroaching winter ice and weather, highlighting the psychological strains of such remote environments. Final thoughts. Haven's design is smaller and simpler than other proposed designs such as ESA's Moon Village or the Diana Habitat concept. It's unique in that it supports 2 different crew types, with an emphasis on its port-like functions, supporting arrivals with training and acclimatization. What do you think of the Haven design? Will the crew separation help maintain order or cause social division? Share your views in the comments. If you enjoyed this space news video, consider buying me a coffee to help fund more episodes like this. The link is in the description. Space News Live is on Saturday evening or Sunday morning, depending where you watch from. I recap the videos I posted this week, answer questions, respond to comments and chat messages, cover any missed news, and preview upcoming content. I'd love for you to join if you can. Be sure to like and subscribe so you'll see our upcoming videos. We make videos every week covering the space industry with an emphasis on the smaller space startups that aren't covered so well on other channels. See you soon.